Howdy folks, Jamboreeky here. Recently I went to go and see the new live-action Disney Jungle Book movie. Now Disney has done two of the live-action Jungle Book films, but this one is supposed to be a direct remake of the animated 1967 film. Before I discuss this movie, I'd like to talk about something really cool that happened before we went into the screening. In the cinema, they had this promotional feature that was free, anyone could have a go at it. Basically, you stood in front of a green screen and they would put you in the Jungle Book movie poster. How awesome is that? And because it was free, we just jumped on board. Like, oh yeah, sure, totally. And this is the end result. You can see me here at the end without my hat. And then you've got Jamie and Kelly. Yeah, I'm trying to get a bit closer. Is that better? Yeah, that should be better. So yeah, and I feel as if that this feature definitely helped to build up the hype, and it added to the cinema experience, it added to the atmosphere. I really felt more excited about the film because of this. So, well done, whoever came up with this idea. It's a cool idea to add to the cinema experience. For those of you who don't know the Jungle Book story, it goes like this. There is a little boy called Mowgli, he's been raised by wolves in the jungle, and he has to leave the jungle to return to his man village because the evil tiger Shere Khan wants to kill him. So while the original 1967 animated film was goofy and colourful, this take on the Jungle Book is closer to the book. It's dark, gritty, and hyper-realistic. It's very disturbing how far it does go for a Disney movie. It does get quite violent. It does get quite overwhelming in terms of its dark material. And you know what? I think that this is a good thing. I think this is great. Not only is this faithful to the original book, but it's also a way to make sure the film has a different identity to the original 1967 film. My worry about this film was if it was going to be a direct carbon copy clone of the 1967 film. I would have found that redundant. I would have found that pointless. I would have been bored after 5 minutes. The novelty of seeing these characters in a more realistic form would have lasted for about 5 minutes. Yeah, it's cool seeing Baloo, Bagheera, Shere Khan, and Mowgli in a more realistic way, but a film has to hold itself together. It can't just be that. It can't just be that as a novelty, as a gimmick. This movie goes for a lot of twists and turns that are very different to the original, which I liked. These twists and turns added something to the film, gave it its own style, gave it its own direction that made it special, that made it unique, that actually advanced it in some ways. There were little creative ideas that I definitely liked more than the original. There are things that happen, especially towards the end of the film, that are drastically different to the original movie, but I liked them. It added to the movie. It made sense in the context of what kind of story this movie was trying to tell. However, the film doesn't completely ignore the fact that it's trying to pretty much pay homage to the 1967 film. There are little nuances and details that remind audiences that, yeah, this still is pretty much a remake of the original. We've just made some little changes along the way to make it a bit more special, a bit more different, new and exciting. However, the film doesn't completely ignore the fact that technically it's still kind of a remake, a homage to the 1967 animated film. So there are little nuances and details that are pretty much love letters to the original movie. Little things here and there that you'll notice, that pay homage, that, you know, respect the original at the same time, while also trying to tell a new, exciting take on the story. They also kept two songs from the 1967 film, I Wanna Be Like You and Bare Necessities. I'll admit that I Wanna Be Like You seems a bit forced into the movie. It seems to come out of nowhere. We've got this dark, gritty scene where King Louis is a bit like a mafia gangster, and he's in the dark, and it's all a bit brooding, it's a bit sinister and threatening, and then suddenly he's like, I wanna be like you, and whoa, okay. It feels like it's just put there for the sake of it. It doesn't seem naturally involved, it doesn't seem like it's put there organically. But Bare Necessities is definitely well handled. It's really sweet. It doesn't seem like it's shoved into the film. It's a nice little moment that doesn't last too long, but doesn't last too short either. It's a nice length, and it's just really sweet to see this adorable song in a live-action format for a little while, and both actors do a brilliant job performing it. Now, the animals are all done through motion capture CGI, and I loved the animal animation for this movie. It's definitely realistic and uncanny valley, but at the same time, there's something a bit human about the way they move, especially in their eyes. There's a strong emotion, very subtle, but you can see these emotions and the way that the characters move. There's something very readable about it, and it fits the voices. It goes along with the voices. It fits the emotions. I mean, one of the problems I had with the film Plague Dogs is that it has these very expressive, very emotional voiceovers for these characters, but the characters move in a really realistic way, and they don't have very emotional faces, and it's quite jarring. But with The Jungle Book, I feel as if the voices go along with their faces, their facial expressions, their movements. It fits for me. I like it. Whoever cast this movie is a genius. I'm serious, because these voice actors suit the roles so well. Yes, they sound very different to the original voices, but I like that. It's new, it's refreshing. And at the same time, these voices fit the characters so well. They are so perfect. Bill Murray is his usual dry, cheeky self, which is perfect for Baloo. Ben Kingsley has this regal voice that's brilliant for Bagheera, that's it. I don't know what happened there. But Chris Walken plays King Louis, and his accent and his cadences and his vocal mannerisms fit the character well, because they play King Louis as this kind of mafia gangster character, so Walken fits it. It fits it so well. And Scarlett Johansson has this very seductive and rich voice, and I love it. So good. And then you've got Idris Elba as Shere Khan. I mean, come on, it's Idris Elba. He's got this strong, raw voice that's perfect for Shere Khan's malicious character. Neil Sethi also steals the show as Mowgli. For a child actor, he was amazing. I think he definitely sells the role, and he also helps us to believe in this world and this atmosphere, and believe that Mowgli is sharing the same screen as these CGI animals. It's a stellar performance. I love this movie's take on Mowgli. Yeah, he can be whiny, but some kids are. They can be obnoxious. But at the same time, there's something kind of badass about him. He definitely adapts to his surroundings. He can take advantage of things around him to invent creations to help him survive in the jungle. Plus, you can definitely tell that he wants to learn to respect the jungle. He wants to care for the animals around him. And when he sees an animal in danger, he uses his inventions to help save them. He's a really sweet, cool, and awesome kid. I also loved the jungle in this movie. It can be very dark, brooding, and sinister, but it can also be stunning, pretty, and beautiful. It's a great pleasure to watch this jungle and really be immersed in the atmosphere of it. Plus, I definitely admired how they tried to make it feel coarse, make it feel dangerous and mucky. As Mowgli traveled through the jungle, he kept getting scratches and cuts to show how dangerous it is. I find it annoying in movies when they have an actor go through a dangerous, coarse environment and they stay pristine and pretty and presentable. No, that wouldn't happen. So kudos to this film for going for a more realistic take on jungle survival. Now, I've been lavishing this movie with loads and loads of praise, but surely I've got some problems with it. Yeah, but they're very minor, very, very, very small little issues with it. First of all, a couple of the fights are a bit blurry. The way they're shot and edited goes a bit too fast. It's a bit too energetic. It's a bit hard to read what's happening on screen, but that's only for a couple moments, a couple fights. Plus, this movie is trying to go for this theme of camaraderie and community, but it's a bit hard to pull that message off when you've got a community of predators and prey that want to eat each other. So there are little moments they're trying to give this uplifting feeling of like, oh, the jungle is together, we fight as one. It's a little iffy. Overall, The Jungle Book stunned me. It blew me away. I was amazed. To be honest, I enjoyed it more than the 1967 film. It takes these directions and routes that are very sophisticated, refreshing, and entertaining. It's well executed, it's fun, it's humorous, it's wonderful. I really highly recommend it. Go see it, go watch it. It's an example of a remake done excellently. It manages to pay homage affectionately while doing some very interesting new things. So, have you seen The Jungle Book? If you have, then let me know what you thought of it in the comments section below. Cheerio, folks.